They're all young. Not very big.
That's... So you just gotta know where they live.
Nope, did I miss them? Just going into the trees.
Well, first of all, they're... Yeah, just bovines.
Is it?
The moo cows. See how that road
loops around?
Yeah. Why?
Why?
That's why you get a truck in there to get that oil out of there.
Oh, the so oh, the
truck, truck can't turn there.
Big truck, yeah.
Yeah. And most of these roads are maintained by oil companies too.
He knew what he was gonna do for sure. Went off the edge, it looked like.
driving on one of these roads and went down on the side hill where there's a bunch of ruts and drove down through there, and I turned around and I went down a couple miles, turned around, came back, and there was a rattlesnake laying on the road that I'd run over.
Jeez. Yeah, the first one I saw was when I was at Luke. Thank you. rabbit shooting. You hear that shot just now?
It was Bailey. Maybe it was Brian.
Out in the field hunting right now. Let me know when you leave. Carol said there's heavy fog. Little buck on the left, better buck on the right. Neither one of them anything to get excited about. And there's some down below running towards them. I could get out and shoot into the bank, wild them up for all the hunters, huh? Disappeared. Dark. Just hoping it was that wolf again. I'd shoot him. Whoever, the non-residents that came through here decided that that little. Yeah, this is a different kind of country.
For sure. See, at home, this would be alders on the sides, and it'd be wet mud right in where we're driving right now.
Right.
Then you come around the corner, and the road's flooded because there's a beaver dam. Beavers flooded the... flooded it right out.
lawns. There's the fawn there, and there's two of them down under the draw, but you can't see the two down under the draw.
Yeah, I think that's his truck. Looks like he stopped right in the road.
Yeah, that's his truck.
Yep.
Three county license plate.
No, I don't see him either. I see a white barrel.
There's a mule deer right there, standing in the road where that orange was.
To the right or to the left of his truck?
Yeah, uh-huh.
Wait, left or right? There.
Over there where them three tracks were at.
Is that to the right?
One doe, two does, three does, four does.
How far are they? Pretty close to his truck?
No. No, they go to the left of his truck about 300 yards. And that ridge. They're looking at him.
I can't get them. I can't find him. Son of a gun. You still see him?
I took it off of him.
Oh.
I was looking around, so they were going to go off of that top anyway. So I'm going to get field glasses there. I'm going to watch. No, you follow that ridge clear to the end where it falls off.
Mm-hmm.
There's one hump, and then there's the next hump. He's clear out on the end.
I got him.
I see him. He's walking.
Yeah, he gave up on that buck. Either it took off running or he saw it and he goes, that ain't as big as I thought. All right, well, he's a long ways out there.
Yeah, I got him in the camera good. I'm making a movie of him walking along. He's looking at us.
What's that?
He's looking at us.
Yeah. All right. So much for that. We have another small 2-point standing out in front of us at about 50 yards. He might be a 3 on the front side. Yeah, he's a 3. 3x2. The little guy.
He's eating.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
another big one back there. There's quite a few big antelope in here this year.
Of course, we don't have a tag.
We're sitting there, we're parked and looking at stuff, and here comes a doe and a two-point running over hill. Pretty good two-point. And so I looked real quick, you could see it. And so we walked over to the edge, see if we could see where they went. Nah, can't see it. Went back, sat in the truck. We're visiting a little bit, about 40 yards in front of us. A 2x3 steps up onto the road.
2x3?
Yeah, and he's sitting there eating. John's videoing him. He goes, "That's a trophy." Is it not? That is a spindly little 18-month-old 2x3.
That would have been a trophy for me.
There was another one with them. Okay. One was bigger, and the other one looked like a doe, but by the time I get my field glasses up, I...
God, there's about a dozen antelope right there.
The other one's a two-point also?
Yeah.
So there's actually three in them, because that one was a 2x3. But, ask John how many of these Minnesotan guys would have let that little buck go stand there. Right there, about 40 yards out, eating grass. And dumber in a box of rocks, because he's just a baby anyway, so you know you could have got your rifle out and shot him while he's looking at you.
Yeah.
Well, I think we're going to start heading out of here. I don't want to stick around too long. I'm not seeing much.
Yeah, well, I'm just going to kind of keep cruising a little bit with these guys moving around. You got the Minnesota guys, you got the California guys.
The California guy walked over the hill without a gun.
No, he had a gun.
Did he?
Yeah. He's got one of them Elbrock or whatever backpacks that shoved the gun down inside.
Oh, he's an elk hunter, huh?
Yeah.
He's an Alaskan hunter.
Yeah. So, yeah, no, he's got his gun. I spotted him.
Well, he's missing. I mean, he's sitting in the wrong spot. He missed out on three deer. They were only about 100 yards away from him.
Yeah.
He didn't see him. Well, yeah. John would have punched his tag on that one, though.
Oh, absolutely. That was a beautiful deer. I would have had that mounted.
In your defense, John, they get bigger the easier they are to load in the truck.
Yeah. Yeah, so that one there was really playing with fate, because it would have been really easy to put in the truck.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm gonna spend about another hour out here and then head back into town and head over the mountain. I don't think I want to be held up.
Did them people? Did you pay for your last day too?
Yeah.
Well, I think the wind's going to kick up today, it feels like.
Yeah. Well, I got up on the top over here and started blasting. My goodness, the truck.
Yeah, yeah.
The wind was just bumping the side.
And I think that's kind of like watching that one little buck, and he's acting all weird when he's out of the wind. Then when he gets in the wind, then he starts running. And like, I got to figure out how to get out of here. But he just come right up onto the road, eating the grass, right out there in front of us. I said, "John, did you catch that?" Yeah, no bucks.
Oops, he's running away. I don't know where he is. There he is.